Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to a new business in town and a new business owner. It's called Bootleggers. You may have seen it. It's on Hillcrest Parkway in Dublin. I was intrigued and stopped by, met Stephanie. This is Stephanie Record. Welcome to you, Stephanie. All right, so this is your place, Bootleggers. How'd you come up with the name Bootleggers, Stephanie?
Because I bootleg antiques. I bring them from state to state. Mm-hmm. That's bootlegging antiques.
All right, and you love for people to stop by and see you because you actually have authentic antiques. You know, some people will put that name up on a business and you go in and look around and it's kind of like, well, okay, it's old, but I don't know if it qualifies for an antique. So let's talk about some of the things you have in the store. In the background right now is a beautiful sign that you have, Stephanie. You really are into signs, into tools, into older types of furniture. Let's talk about some of the things that you're really drawn to bring into the store.
That's an old Sinclair gasoline sign, and it's very rare, hard to find. Two-sided porcelain, and I like old, unique, and hard to find, rare items.
Mm-hmm. So double-sided porcelain sign. How old is that?
That's 1930s.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, you got to display that. Be nice to display both sides wherever you hang it, but it would be a real collector's piece. And a lot of people are into that for your man cave or if you got an old barn that you're redoing, things like that. It really would class it up. Some people like it would, if they have classic cars, they display them in their garage. Be nice to hang that sign in there. I'm sure you have some traffic on that. It is a very rare item. And you have many rare items in here that you just don't see everywhere. Let's talk about a couple of the other signs that you have while we're on that topic.
We have an Atlantic gasoline sign, and it's rare. Mm-hmm. It's two-sided porcelain, too. Ah. And then we got golf, two-sided porcelain.
Golf sign. Yeah, you don't see those hardly at all, do you?
No.
Yeah. They're hard to come by. What about a couple more? Is that the cream of the crop, so to speak?
Pretty well. Mm-hmm. Those are my favorites. And then I have Coca-Cola. It's two-sided porcelain, and it's a big one, and it's usually hard to find, too.
Yeah. Porcelain.
Yes.
Right? Says a lot about it right there,
right.
Doesn't it?
They're not painted signs. They're porcelain signs.
Mm-hmm. So how old will that Coke sign be?
1940s.
Wonderful. Mm. Have some really neat stuff in the store, ladies and gentlemen. You should stop by and see us. You're located on Hillcrest. What's the address?
610 Hillcrest Parkway, Dublin, Georgia.
All right, we got it, Stephanie. Stephanie Record, like a record that you would play. That's a good way to remember. That's the way I remember it as well. Once again, we want you to stop by because you have a lot of unique pieces of furniture as well. Now, people really get into furniture, and you have a couple of pieces back that we were looking at that are really unique. Let's talk about those.
I have an old desk that was made from an old buggy company that come from off of a buggy. And it's primitive with the old square nails.
Okay, Stephanie, tell us about a few other pieces of furniture because there's some neat things in the store.
Okay, we have an old cabinet from out of an old doctor's office. It lights up, and when you open it, you can still smell the medicine and stuff from the old cabinet.
Oh, nice. About what era would that be from?
1940s.
Okay.
And we got that actually from an old doctor's wife, and we have this is a old porcelain gas cook stove. It still works, working condition. We got it from an 80-year-old woman. It still operates off gas. That's a working cigarette machine. It still works. You could actually put it in your man cave and restock it and get a pack of cigarettes for 40 cents. Still has the original key, everything. This is an older piece. This come out of an older home in Savannah. It's an old jelly cupboard. Everything's all original. Nothing's ever been redone to it. I've only seen a few of these in the years that I've been dealing in antiques. Usually have holes or messed up or the backs out of them or something, but this is all original. Had the original paint, everything. We have some unique pieces like this too. This is Haywood Wakefield chair from the 50s, 60s. These are very rare, very collectible. A lot of people like the 50s, 60s look. Now, this is a beautiful leather top desk. A lot of people collect these and want them for their home. It's 1940s. Mm-hmm. This is an old cabinet from the post office, and they say the postmaster used to hide his pistol up in here. This is all original. Nothing's been done to it. This is an old blanket chest from the 1800s. Thank you. It's a unique piece. I think you'd be thrilled to stop in and see us at Bootleggers Antiques. This is unique. Big wide boards is made from. Got a drawer. We have many unique pieces like this. This is an area I'm most proud of. All of the old tools and the old blacksmith tools, farm tools. This is very unique. There's a lot of old tools that you can't find nowhere else. We have people come in all the time that looks for stuff everywhere, but they can't find it nowhere, but they can find it here. If you want to come in and look around, you will find pieces like anvils, blacksmith pieces, blowers, railroad from the B&O Railroad, old farm tools, anvils, old pulleys, old wrenches, old gas can, oil cans. If you are not looking to buy anything, we just love for you just to come in and look around and just look and see what we do have and look at our antiques. Just come on in. We enjoy sharing the story of our tools with you. Just of you coming in and looking around and sharing our story, and you share your story with us. This is a forge anvil, forge blacksmith blower. That's what they use to blow the fire when the blacksmiths need to keep the fire going while they were doing their forging. We have an old axe from B&O. It's marked. The old railroad light with the red lenses are very hard to find. They are marked with different railroads. If people need parts, I have parts, and then I have different lenses. We have a John Deere pedal tractor, all metal. You can't find them all metal like that no more. Three outboard motors. They all have compression. The outboard motors are from the 50s.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've worked our way or tried to work our way through this beautiful store. There's so many things in here. It's just incredible to be able to see. You have everything from coins. You have memorabilia from the Civil War. You have a Colt 44 in your hand right now, don't you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Tell me about that. Gosh, that was a find.
It's 1863 Colt Civil War Army revolver. We actually wrote a letter to Colt, and they wrote a letter back and told us that it was actually shipped and everything in August and told us all kinds of stuff about it.
So you have the paperwork on that as well?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the history of it. What a unique find. And again, there's so many things in here. You need to come in and have a look around. You could spend a lot of time in here with all the wonderful things that you have. Again, from coins, from collectibles, antiques throughout the store. We invite you to come by. I know you'd love for people to stop by and visit with you. What are your store hours?
Monday through Saturday, 10 a.m. to 6 p.m.
Okay. And your phone number again?
478-410-8098.
Okay. Love to see you come on down. It's Bootleggers Antiques. This is Stephanie Reckert, and she'd love for you to either call or come by, but you're going to love what you see inside of this store. There's so much more to see. We've only scratched the surface, so we hope to see you soon at Bootleggers Antiques on Hillcrest. Thank you for sharing with us.
Thank you.